always kind of held on to this philosophy that, like, I don't like to marry myself to one thing when it comes to my creativity, because I always want to be open to whatever God's desires may be for me. Back home. LA is not home. I don't know if you guys know that, but we're in LA. We just landed. I have a ton of stuff with me right now because I'm working on a couple different projects. I traveled with two suitcases. Now I have three. I had to borrow one from a friend. And I still had to leave some stuff behind. But excited to be working, happy to be working, and happy to be back home. Had a busy day today. Today we're going to see Greg Lauren and Brandon Lake. So if you guys don't know, Greg Lauren is a clothing designer, well established, very successful, and Brandon Lake is probably, to my knowledge, the number one gospel artist in America right now. So. It's my first time meeting him. We've actually worked together before, and we've talked a lot, but it's our first time meeting, so that's going to be great. And then Greg and I have talked and met before, but this is my first time at his studio, so really excited and honored that he was that he gave us the ability to document some of it so you guys could see. But yeah, right now we're heading to the house. I need to shower, change, and then start putting together some looks for my other client. All within like an hour and a half time frame, so that we can go meet Brandon at the coffee shop and then head over to see Greg at his studio. So, long day. Right now, from orders from our client that I have to deliver to before he arrives. I mean, before he leaves to go to New York. He's here in LA, so I have a lot of that going on right now. I know some of this stuff I'm already not going to keep, so I'm only going to pull out the stuff that are potentials. The good thing is that him and I are similar sizes, so what I do is I put together the outfit, I put it on myself, and then I send him a picture of it, or I send his team a picture of it, and then they let me know if it's going to work or not. These are fire. Love this jacket. This is fire. It's Bianca Saunders. Shining sick. I want to pair it with these boots. The blues don't match that well, but we'll see what happens.
The texture on this feels incredible.
Not really a rain boots guy, but I like that they're not that tall. And the colorway is kind of cool. So. Maybe I will become a rain boots kind of guy. Let's try them on and see. I'm actually not mad at this. This is kind of sick. I could wear this for sure. Thank you so much. We're now heading to Greg Lauren's studio. To chat with him and start the design process for Greg's new coat. And this is for the launch of his new single and a tour he's going to be doing and eventually an album after that. So everything is surrounding the new single that he has coming out, which is called Coat of Many Colors. And Greg and I are going to work on a coat design for Brandon. And get it going. So I'm really excited about this. I'm really thankful, just in a really humbled place to know that I have this opportunity This is something that I've dreamt of, and I'm just, you know, really blessed that God is pulling this together for me right now, and not just for me, but for Brandon and everything. So, yeah, I hope you guys enjoy the rides. It'll be fun.
I think the mistake people make, which I think is what's great, is this is the opposite of what you're doing, which is some people jump to think they're an expert in something. And I think that you've got to learn the foundation of whatever it is you want to do.
Yeah.
And now it's a beautiful time because I think if you have that, if you're inspired to do something, if you're inspired to create in any medium, the most beneficial thing is to actually learn the foundation of that craft.
So we finally made it. Like I said, a couple minutes behind schedule, which I don't like. But Greg is cool about it, obviously. So we are heading into his studio space now. Gonna give him a chat and see what's going on. Looks like Brandon's all the way down there, which is awesome. And then, and yeah, we're really excited.
How are you, man?
See you.
Looking good.
Hey, what's up?
Brandon.
Brandon. That was on Wednesday, and then, yeah,
So, let me warn you now, there's a lot of creativity, a lot of stuff you're going to see that just don't let it get you, I mean, let it take you wherever you want it to.
Yeah, love
it. But it's going to sidetrack the thoughts or may inspire stuff. That's what we do here. It's all about inspiration, creativity, but we're actually in production mode. So what's exciting to me is you're seeing, you know, like,
this is the new line.
Well, so you're seeing here as a mix of what we're going to really ship literally like in a month, as well as creating a new collection. And there's always special projects, you know, whether it's a Mother's Day gift or...
Yeah, right.
Projects and all kinds of things. So there's always things going on. This is kind of quiet. Okay. Usually, it's just like, it's either really quiet like this, or like in a minute I may have to step away for a minute while we're working for an interview, or like someone from GQ's coming by, which is cool. I don't know if you've ever...
Yeah,
it's awesome. GQ Thailand, so it might be interesting for them to see, you know, what we're doing.
Yeah, absolutely.
So... Thank you.
Yeah,
awesome. So there's plenty of stuff around here which I want you to see because the goal today. Like, you're taller than I realized, so now we've got to figure that out.
No, it's the boots.
No, but I was like, okay, we got to figure that out.
I'm a big boy.
It's good. So I know you love this. This is like your. This is a very Justin piece. Actually, I would say there are about a few hundred pieces that are very Justin.
Very easily.
So this is the world, and this is our play table because I thought we'd have a look. So literally, this is me. This is my little sketch I did. That was just for you to have. That's for you. That was just like an old thing. I didn't know how.
Stop.
Wearing more of the ponytail now, and you have the shaved side.
Well, no, but when I perform, I always do hair down.
So we needed this.
But
is the
traveling,
moment.
I'll just like put it up. This is amazing.
Just a quick. Like I do a lot of quick pencil sketches that are very spontaneous and that just capture the mood.
It's hanging on some kind of rack as a prop in the stage as well, right? And then when we go into Coat of Many Colors, I walk back, I put the coat on, I'm only in that coat for that song.
Got it.
And it's just like a special, I don't want to overdo it, I want it to be tasteful,
moment.
I want it to be cheesy of like, oh, he's in costume. It's like, no, this is a moment where it's like, I'm clothing myself in the Father's pride.
Exactly.
Just this song, we're going to have a moment. And then it's like somebody comes and takes it off me, puts it back on the thing, and then we're back on, you know?
Yeah.
So music video, photo shoot. The priority though is, the biggest goal is what's gonna make the sickest photo to make the record cover.
Exactly.
Cause then I start looking through stuff. I found my baby blanket.
Going in this coat.
Yeah.
And we can do that in a way that we preserve it. So let's say that's like, to me, that would be incredible if it was sort of on the inside lining.
Agreed.
So that especially is a moment when this happens, you see it, you know?
Yeah.
And in a photo shoot, I assume you'll be, you know, it's like all you need is that. And you
we could even write on it some extra lyrics there on the inside or something.
Yeah, cool.
And then
the whole lining, you know, I'm going to bring Zachy over here in a little bit, but, you know, we were talking about, obviously there are traditional lining fabrics, but, but the idea was that, I mean, it could be like a whole side could be filled with lyrics.
Yeah.
You could literally sit and you could either send me, I can do it. You can sit and scribble and draw, and that just finds its way into the inside of the coat.
Love it.
Could be hidden, could be in the arm, it could be in the pocket flap, you know? Yeah. So it's really, it's whatever we want that to be.
Yeah, right. So, right. But the details still look tailored.
So the question becomes, do we want that or do you want, if you're liking this, then we get into really these pieces. And these are great for the small details that someone, that's what you see second. You see this, you see this, you see this, because we're looking at you.
Yeah.
So we want to put the special things up here to frame this, you know? We wanted to have more of, now that we're sort of seeing and we wanted to have a little softer feeling, we could actually, the pieces could be stitched to each other without this piece. It's a little more, when I say dangerous, a little more,
it is, because they'll pull and,
you know, one wrong move, but but it'll give that softer feel. It'll, we can reinforce it, and because it'll be lined still.
Yeah.
You know. This is good.
So happy.
Good.
Greg, this is crazy. This is so good. And I love just the little denim patches in here. This is so sick. I feel at home in this.
What'd you say?
I feel at home in this.
Yeah.
It looks like home.
I think that anybody can be an expert at anything.
Yeah.
Because, I mean, maybe it's just because of this is like the level at which I am with all the things that I enjoy doing. But I think as an artist, you have that understanding. Because as an artist, you see things from so many different perspectives.
Yeah.
That there's always something that somebody else is doing that may just be a little bit more fine-tuned in how you look at it. You know, like, I got a skateboard, like, I would never say I'm an expert at skateboarding, because there's 100,000 people that are better than me at it, you know, or approach it differently than me. I just really love how just completely unorthodox and, like, you know, just like random, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Like, I love this.
But you see,
and I think this helps tell the story.
If you put this on, it would be a little bit, it's very structured.
Yeah,
it's
right.
Material.
Right.
So we can.
Well, yeah, it doesn't have to be the material,
but
style.
Right.
I mean,
yeah. And this is a size 3. So what's interesting is the three. There's not a huge difference between the 3 and the 4.
Yeah.
He can wear either, and the 3 ends up being a little slimmer. Right. And a little bit more form fit.
Yes. Like the 3 on the shoulders.
Right,
the,
I agree.
And the sleeves.
Yeah, I agree.
So if we elongate a 3, so that, you know, it seems to work on you. Because a 4 is intentionally, it's going to do the thing that you're not liking, which is, it's, even though it's only maybe a quarter of an inch or half an inch in the different spots, it's that much more where it
This is
drops.
Like hugging me perfect around here.
Hmm.
Brandon, remind me, it's gold, red.
Yeah, just, I mean, the only colors I really mentioned in the song is gold, red, and white.
And white,
but,
okay,
So you see like a fabric like this.
We don't have to lean too far into that. No one's gonna like
So I think that we should remove.
But if that's in there, it's.
I think we should take out any blues that's not denim. Not all of it, but some of it.
Let's just see what it looks like.
And then, like, this one come out.
I think it's nice for a little pop somewhere.
Maybe
the blue-green a little bit, you know, just to...
Yes,
just,
exactly.
Just having it.
Yeah, like, not all of it, but, yeah, like, this one is, I think,
let me just get behind this.
A little too dark.
Exactly, put this. The coat.
You need a little bit, yeah.
Because if it's, like, so pieced together in the front, and then the back is, like, a completely different world.
So here's another question. So then...
Which I don't think is impossible, but...
Can you do this, multiple pieces, and you do it in this triangle shape, and then from here down, we do more of like, find one or two pieces that is like this and a denim?
Yeah, I mean, I think
So you're saying like this, basically, like the jacket that he's wearing, because this is one piece.
Flop
and
it,
then
though.
It,
right.
So flop it.
Well, this has, see how this is two larger pieces and smaller pieces, but if you look at something like this, even, see, this is our typical, you know what I mean? Or
Let's see. Just try this on for a second, just so we can see. This is a different shape. He won't. I don't think he's gonna like this shape. But it just because we know we have a lot to still fill out. So this is gonna. That's a great strip. This is a great strip.
Yep.
And I love that this. This even when you spoke about this, you lit up.
Yeah.
You know
right.
what I mean. So this is.
That's true.
So it's gonna bring that to the piece. You know?
Yeah.
And you'll look down and you'll feel something when you see this
right.
over here on a sleeve. You know what I mean?
Yep.
What's the verdict on the wedding dress?
I think we're gonna use the
maybe
strings
just a string.
For the
I'll leave.
Okay.
Just in case we want to use it, and if not, it's totally fine. But. And then my baby blanket.
Oh yeah, we never saw that. Yeah, we never saw
that. I mean, that on its own is a gorgeous piece of destroyed textile that has, talk about a story.
Yeah.
Well,
I like what you mentioned initially where we potentially put it in the lining somewhere.
Because we don't want to touch this. I don't think we want to cut this.
No. I want to keep it as complete as possible.
Oh, really?
And we'll just pop it in the lining or whatever. Something.
So I mean, like it would almost like be...
It's tricky because of the size of it.
Yes. Like some of it will have to get cut, but we're not.
Oh, I don't mind this getting cut because then I just go, hey, this is my baby blanket, but it's like.
Well, you know what feels
in my cut.
What would be gorgeous? I think. Yeah, I think you're right. I think if we let's say we started by cutting in half, and this, for example, now we have to see on stage in the photo shoot, but I still think this lining the inside of this, for example, down here. You know, is just be so good.
Yeah.
What's going on, everybody? You guys have seen us kind of in our world for a minute, which has been great. Really been loving this process. I'm legit in heaven right now. This is like not just a dream come true, but like this is what really fuels me and makes me feel whole and complete in a sense. And yeah, like I mentioned before we came in here, just like completely honored by the opportunity and everything. I'll take you guys to the coat a little bit. We've been in this world trying to figure out how to piece this thing together. And I think we're kind of finally at a very happy place. But as you guys can imagine, there's so much in here to kind of pull from as references and stuff. And I'm just really happy with where we've landed. I think it's like... It's gonna be amazing once it's all the way put together. And yeah, again, like I'm just like so grateful. Like I'll probably go home and cry. That's how grateful I am. I mean, I don't know maybe, but anyway, it's just just super grateful and thankful for everything. Brandon, Greg, the whole team here, this entire space. You know, the energy in here is like amazing. And yeah, just being able to do this is like match made in heaven, in my opinion. I don't think it gets any better than this. So. Humbled and grateful for sure.
A part that just fit in the whole aesthetic of the record, but
I mean, honestly, I think we need to redo your whole wardrobe.
Yeah, right.
Because this is you, like you know what I mean. Like this works.
You know, when it, I mean, it literally looks like you look like I think how you want to feel.
Yes.
Exactly. Does that make sense?
Yes,
like it feels
100%.
Like you look like you, and I just met you.
Right. Right. This is fun.
It's a little bit.
You know, that's
street.
What happens here. You start playing, you know.
A little bit of street, a bit of like rock and roll, and then it's got Western. It's got. It's literally who I am.
This every part of
I'm a city boy. I'm a country boy. I'm like leather and denim. You know what I'm saying?
It's every part of your
Apache. It's got. And if you, I was able to sit down and tell you my whole story. It's literally like. 5 years here, and then God did this crazy thing, and then it took me here, and then 5 years later, 7 years later, then it brought me here, and it's literally been, which is probably most people's stories, but it's been season after season of sewing and working my tail off for here, and then it was like feeling this holy discontentment and going, I know there's something else, but waiting on it till God opened the door, and then boom, this was the right thing.
Yeah.
And me and my wife together making those decisions. So it's I just resonate with the putting together of things that have different histories. And probably in our space, nobody has been a part of more collectives and groups and featured with different people than, and I never asked for it. It's just like something God's done to show finally, you don't have to just stay in one lane. It's like, get out there, learn from each other,
you create things that you never could have created by yourself. Then you create something beautiful that multiple people look in and go, oh, I see myself in that. And this person who doesn't look anything like me goes, whoa, I see myself in that.
Yeah. Maybe because I grew up, I always have been around the water. Just anything sailor vibe. Yeah.
Gotta make sure you get his eyes on everything. Well, there's just a really cool orange tone just in that tiny.
Dang, this is a vibe.
Yeah. I tell people all the time, denim is like my favorite fabric. Because you can do absolutely anything with it and it looks good every time. This is insane.
Unless it's bad denim.
Yes, exactly. Unless it's bad denim, you're absolutely
You know, it's not like pizza. You know, pizza, like even bad pizza is good. Bad That's denim true. Can be like...
No, you're absolutely
bad. Bad denim just reminds me of my childhood at Myrtle Beach. It's just like
bad denim is never a good thing. This
is it. So good. See what you would direct as a film director, because I think there's something about your vision and also you seem to have the ability as an artist to also listen.
Yes.
Like you seem to really observe and take things in, and I've noticed that even in the work you really observe. Mm-hmm. And you know, sometimes people love to just speak first.
Yes. Absolutely. Do you know what I mean? And those are the moments you chase. You know, it's like there are moments in sports that people talk about, like when you're chasing that, like connecting.
Yeah.
And for me as an artist, it's like sometimes a brush stroke can bring that kind of magical feeling, just like, oh wow. But like today, it felt like you could feel everyone who came here today. It was just everyone was here and just brought
the energy kept going.
Yeah. It was so a great, great energy.
Yeah. So good. Well, I can't thank you enough.
Love it.
Don't even have words.
Wait till next time. I'm gonna bring out more stuff for you to try.
On my vision board right now. Like, I want to be able to work with Greg or a designer such as Greg. I mean, I put on my Instagram caption like a month or two ago under a picture, like, I want to be the creative director at Ralph Lauren. Like, Greg Lauren is the nephew of Ralph Lauren. So it's like, not saying that that's why, like, but it's just like, it's so linear, like how it all is lining up, because you know, not saying that I'm about to be working for Greg, but you know, it's just, he's the one designer that I have really felt strongly connected to since I've begun this fashion journey of like pieces and style. Like the minute I saw a Greg Lauren piece for the first time, I was like, yo, I feel like I could do that. Like, it made me feel like, it was one of those things where it's like, dang, like he's doing what I could be doing. But like, I had that feeling, but it was more so in a space of like, dang, this is so inspiring to know that like somebody that has a similar taste level and design aesthetic is living their dream out at the level at which I would imagine myself doing so. So, and it's really cool, like being able to talk to him today, being able to like just politic and kind of pick his brain and vice versa. And it was really cool because the interactions were balanced. Like, if there wasn't any moment where it's like I'm sitting here like asking him, fanning over him, like it was just balanced conversation. Like, felt like a peer, like a friend, which is what I really appreciated and enjoyed the most, because there was no pressure in any of it. Like, it was just us genuinely being in a space and allowing each other to freely live, and then like coming together with our thoughts and our opinions on stuff, and then taking that into the next step. So I'm really excited to see what the jacket's gonna look like. Got a couple weeks and then it'll be done apparently. So really looking forward to that. Really looking forward to seeing what's gonna come of it all. It was really cool to see his team. That was just round one. So, you know, the second round will be in a couple weeks, and then we'll finalize everything And I'll be able to say that, like, I, like, you know, basically co-designed a piece with Greg Lauren for Brandon Lake, and, you know, I don't even know where to go from there. But yeah, it's just like, you know, your dreams can happen, your dreams can come true. God is listening to your heart. He's listening to the things that you want. And if you just continue to be diligent and continue to put him first, you know, then all those things will be given to you. There's a Bible verse that says exactly that, that I've been holding on to a lot recently. That says, seek first the kingdom and all will be added. And, you know, I think I found, like, just moving to LA has given me the opportunity to reignite that fire for God that I've had to, like, truly seek him first, because I know that everything that I desire will come through that. Like, me trying to chase things on my own, like, I sent Greg Lauren Instagram DMs starting back 4 years ago, like, probably even longer, asking for an opportunity to work with him, like, putting together a deck of, like, what I would like to do, you know, under, as, like, an influencer type of vibe. And, you know, God's basically like, nah, bro, that ain't it. Like, super bummed, because, like, I get a response and it's like, oh, email this person, and I never hear anything back. And then now I'm sitting here in his studio, and, you know, his team is like, oh yeah, I know exactly who you are, like, we love how you wear his pieces. And I'm just like, bro, what? Like, it's just crazy. So I said it in episode one, and I'll say it again now, like, where I am now versus where I was 2 years ago or 4 years ago when I sent that initial DM is, like, it's just monumental. And to know that that this isn't, like, the end. I'm 28 years old, like, and to know that, like, there's so much more, like, 3 or 4 years from now, who knows what'll happen. Like, it's just like, bro, it's crazy. It's funny, it's like all this stuff happens and I just want to keep doing more. You know, it's like, not that I'm not satisfied or grateful, because I am, but it's just like, I just want to keep doing more. And I think that that's the part that really makes me feel the best about it all, because none of it feels like a burden, none of it feels like, you know, oh, I gotta go back and do more of this and do this and that. It's like, no, I'm just back to, like, all right, what's the next step? Like, how do I keep this going? So, cheers to keeping it going.